levels. But I mean, never know, because I'm not going to play through the whole game as of yet. From what I see here, graphically and the controls themselves, everything about the game so far is awesome. Like, a big one bad thing to say about the game, maybe the sound effects are not quite as good, of course, because it's the NES, and they have the ability to produce the most fantastic sound effects, but it still doesn't sound that bad at all. I never was really the greatest at this game, but I must say that from what I see here, I believe this was on the Sega Master System as well. This gives the Sega Master System version a run for its money. Now, I know there was an Aladdin game that released in Europe on the NES, but I don't think it released in the United States. I'm not sure if it's the same thing as this right here. I have to look that up. And I'm not sure if there is an unlicensed cartridge of this at all. I'm not sure. That's going to be very interesting to see. See, this enemy right here keeps running back and forth. He doesn't even realize I'm over here. Wonder if I can get by him. There we go, and we'll see if we can get up here. Let's jump on the enemies and try to kill them so they don't end up getting hit. Freaking guy with the arrow. That's what makes the game a little bit unfair, because when he shoots the arrows off, the arrows kind of like defy gravity, and they go straight down exactly where you're standing. And, what the hell? I think the game just froze. Okay, I'm not sure if that's the game or not, but... okay, let's see here. So, I must say overall, I'm not sure if it's buggy or what the hell, you know, it just froze on me, so... I must say overall, the game is pretty damn impressive from the little bit I played of it. And this is, once again, exactly what it looks like. And once again, I'm not sure if it's a full game or if it's just a few couple levels of it or what the hell it is. And once again, my NES just froze. I'm actually playing this on an emulator, so I shouldn't be having this problem, but apparently the emulator emulates the flaws of the NES as well. And you see a couple of numbers right there on the bottom. That's exactly what the NES looks like when it gets scrambled. You have to pull on the cartridge. Unfortunately, I don't have the cartridge here.
Like your
normal game where you can get shot several times. This game, if you get shot, you're dead. So be really, really careful. So basically, the objective in this game is to get from point A to point B. You have to eliminate your enemies or arrest them, one or the other. And usually at the end of the objective, there is probably an individual that you have to rescue. On the top right-hand side of the screen, it gives you your objectives. It basically tells you what you have to do. Right now, the chef is being held hostage. So the shot, this enemy right here, and his buddy up here seems like he doesn't give a shit. He's just walking around in circles. So as you see here, if you go into your settings right here, you can actually upgrade your police officer and give him better speed, health, damage, clip size, all kinds of crap. You can give him buy him new weapons. And this game is compatible with the Xbox 360 controller, which is pretty nice. See, we have another little introduction right here. There's always donuts being involved in this game. No matter what, like, the first level is a donut shop, for Christ's sakes. See if we can give you an example of arresting the enemy right here. See, he just got arrested. So right now, he's hunched over on the floor. You can actually steal his weapon if you want to. And we have another enemy in this room that's walking around, and we have this bad guy right here. We arrested him. And what we're going to do is we're going to position my partner over here just in case one of these guys come flying through that door. Well, that kind of looks like The Sims kind of a little bit, but let's arrest that enemy right there. You see he's hunched over right in front of his enemy partner right there. He just, once again, doesn't give a crap. He's walking in circles. And then we have another room full of villains over here. We have to pretty much get in here and kill all of them. Try to kill everybody that you can love and shit. What the hell? Oh, I got lucky that time. Killed all the enemies right here. So now what you have to do is, I guess, get to the end of the level right here, and the area is cleared. You definitely have to use your partner in this level, because if you don't, you're going to definitely screw up. By pushing the A button, you can actually send your partner over to wherever the hell you're nearby. You basically walk into this room right here and destroy this drug table, and there's another drug table somewhere around here. Sometimes you just have to charge in there and it's... Well, someone got me from right there, from the other side. So overall, this game right here is awesome. Caught me by surprise. I was kind of like a little worried about the game at first, but I bought it. And I must say that the game itself is very, very awesome.
I'm going in.
There is a little bit of a learning curve right here that you can take a tutorial and it teaches you how to play it. I'll say the game itself is easy enough that you really can probably jump right into the game and enjoy playing it with no problem. The difficulty, though, is definitely a prick. The game is a prick. It is pretty damn hard. You're going to probably want to take some time learning how to play the game first before you jump in and try to destroy each level. I've been playing it for, I want to say, I put probably about 4 or 5 hours into it, and I'm still stuck on level 3. I'm going to keep trying until I eventually beat that level. I must say the game overall is, so far, very, very awesome, and I definitely recommend it. is on the Atari 2600. I must say, maybe. Now, I know for sure if it was on the Atari 2600, it would probably have that blue gradient effect in the background. The 2600, even though it was an old console, it could handle, I believe, 256 colors at once, which allowed it to have the nice gradient effects on certain games. You don't see it on this, of course, just the NES. It's not able to actually do that. Nonetheless, whoever modded this game, I guess hats off to them, because it does look kind of not 8-bit, but something that came out from around the 2600 era. So here's another Super Mario hack, or mod, whatever the hell you want to call it. These were early mods back in the day. Most likely they were modded back in the 90s. This one's called Afro Mario Brothers. And basically what this did was it gave Mario an afro, as you can see here. And it kind of looks like the enemies have afros as well, which is quite interesting. And I guess for back then, even though it's just a simple little mod, it's... back then it was actually something that was pretty damn cool, interesting. And you can see it's completed the level, and Mario has one hell of a freaking afro. Look at that, that's pretty damn crazy. And you see the power box right here. It says afro on it. So whoever modded this, they chose to mod Mario Brothers, not the actual Super Mario Brothers game, but the original Mario Brothers game, which is quite unique. I guess whoever did this, they did it pretty well. It looks just like an afro. Good job to whoever did modded this game. Not sure why the hell you want Mario to have an afro to begin with, but it is funny. Check that out. Here's another Super Mario Brothers hack, or clone, whatever the hell you want to call it. Apparently this one is called Acid Brothers. It's pretty obvious what this is. It's pretty much Super Mario on crack. As you can see here, this is actually a demonstration of what the game looks like, and it's like whoever made this game was on crack. And, what the hell? It's like right away you start off, not in level 1, but you start off in level, whatever the hell this is, I'm not sure. You start off in a water world. And that looks pretty scary down there. You have like some type of a skeleton looking thing popping out of a, it's like a crackhead, I guess. And I guess you go straight down this way, and we have water underneath the water. Check that out. So before the LSD simulator came out on PlayStation, this existed. I guess you can see right here, I'm stuck. What the heck crap is that? And Mario looks kind of different. What the hell's wrong with him? So I guess we have to go down here to get around. Hopefully we don't get stuck. This looks like the bridge from pretty much the end of each world where you defeat Bowser and yeah, I guess it's the end of the level right there. Just thank you, Slick. Okay. What the hell is that? Is that the only level that exists? I guess, whoever created this must have been on some type of a drug or something. I don't know. So here's another hack for Super Mario Brothers called Super Mumble. Not sure what the hell that is, but it looks like some type of an anime thing right there. This was, as you can see there, probably hacked or modded back in 1989. We have a little pink looking character. Looks like some type of an anime thing. Whoever created the character design, did a pretty good job. The animation's quite nice, and the graphics actually look pretty decent. And we have a pinkish purplish looking castle. You can see the boxes right here. disgusting. So here we have another Super Mario Brothers hack. It's called Angry Mario No, something like that. And you can see the demonstration here on the title screen. Looks very, very, very difficult looking. Like, what the hell is this? Who the hell created that level design? Let's check this out.
Second, which is pretty awesome.
fantastic on this game. I love the grip.